Hello and welcome to this episode of MakerBox Mondays. Today I'm going to have a look at a PLA from Carbodion. It's a micro diamond filament, PLA plus micro diamond. So let's have a look after the intro. So this filament is a PLA based filament with micro diamonds or nano diamonds, I'm not sure, micro or nano. But let's have a look at the label, and here they say it's a PLA plus micro diamond, and print temperature should be 220 to 250, and I was printing at 230, and bed temperatures went on to 50°C, and speeds up to 500 mm/s. I didn't test that speed, but that's quite a claim. And cooling 100%, so compared to PLA, it prints a little bit hotter than normal PLA. But here they say Carbodion micro diamond PLA is a high performance diamond enhanced 3D printing filament. It contains functional nano diamonds particles. Nano diamonds are spherical and act as lubricant in the filament extrusion, causing no increase in nozzle wear. The enhanced thermal conductivity of the material enables printing speed up to 500 mm/s. The diamond particles also reinforce the polymer structure, improving the stiffness, strength, and adhesion between the printed layers. The filament is suitable for customer grade and professional 3D printers. Combination of stiffening, strength, wear, resistance, and unique thermal features make it the number one PLA for functional mechanical parts. So it's quite a claim. And since they claim the mechanical parts to be very good on layer adhesion, I decided to test it in my brake test apparatus to see how the layer adhesion was, because they claim that it has very high layer adhesion. And my result showed that it has very poor layer adhesion. It's very easy to break, and I noticed just when I was removing the prints from the bed, sometimes they broke off, and because layer adhesion was so bad. I believe this is the same filament Chris at Practical Printing used for printing out MK2 parts or MK3 parts, and he had to cancel that project because of bad layer adhesion with his filament. And I'm not agreeing with the statements on the label here. That's a good mechanical material. It's it's stiff, but it's very brittle, so it's no use for anything, I think. But it looks, the colors of it is like beige white color, pretty much like the old computer cases back in the day. And I believe that was the reason Chris decided on this filament. He wanted to do a retro MK3 and decided on this filament. But my results for layer adhesion is not very good. But let's have a look at the other prints. So here's my stringing test, and this came out pretty nice. It was a tiny amount of stringing, but very, very little. But as you can see, the layer adhesion is just crumbles. it's no good. But I then printed out Mr. Belly, and that came out pretty nice. It's very smooth finish and like a silky look of the filament. A little bit of drooping here, but that's quite expected. So this print came out pretty nice, but the legs, they fall off. And here's my maker coin. That as well came out looking pretty nice, no issues, so to speak, except the layer adhesion. This came apart when I was removing this from the bed, but print surface is quite nice, so it looks pretty good. So it's it looks nice, but it's not very functional. And finally, I did a Benchy, and that looks pretty good. There was some drooping here in the inside, though. I'm not used to see this kind of drooping, but it's a nice looking Benchy for most parts. So that came out okay. So that was my quick look at the PLA micro diamond from Carbodion. It was a nice looking filament, silky looking, like beige white color. But the mechanical properties they claim are not there in my experience so far. So I don't know if I printed it in the recommended printer temperature and I tried to do that for filament samples to see how they fare. But this will be it for this video. Thank you for watching, and if you like what I'm doing here on the channel, please subscribe and like this video and leave a comment. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.